Hemoglobin is a protein found in red cells that carries oxygen from the lungs to all other organs in the body. Anemia is a condition in which the body does not have enough healthy red blood cells or hemoglobin. As a result, your body does not get enough oxygen-rich blood. The lack of oxygen can make you feel tired or weak. In this video, we will explore everything you need to know about anemia, including its types, causes, symptoms, diagnosis, and treatment options. So let's dive in. Anemia can have various underlying causes, all of which contribute to a decrease in red blood cell count or impaired hemoglobin production. One of the most common causes of anemia is inadequate intake of essential nutrients such as iron, vitamin 12, and folic acid. These nutrients are required for the production of healthy red blood cells. Anemia can also occur due to excessive blood loss, either through a sudden event such as injury or surgery, or through chronic conditions that result in ongoing blood loss. Menstrual bleeding in women, gastrointestinal bleeding, and bleeding disorders such as ulcers or hemorrhages can all contribute to anemia. The bone marrow is responsible for producing red blood cells. Any dysfunction or disorder affecting the bone marrow can disrupt the normal production of red blood cells, leading to anemia. Conditions such as leukemia, myelodysplastic syndrome, and aplastic anemia can all interfere with the production of red blood cells. Certain chronic medical conditions can cause anemia as a secondary effect. These include kidney disease, liver disease, cancer, inflammatory bowel disease, and autoimmune disorders. In these cases, the underlying disease may lead to decreased red blood cell production, increased red blood cell destruction, or impaired iron absorption, resulting in anemia. Some individuals are born with genetic abnormalities that affect the production or structure of red blood cells. Sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, and hereditary spherocytosis are examples of genetic disorders that can cause anemia. Chronic infections such as HIV and AIDS, tuberculosis, and certain parasitic infections can impact the body's ability to produce red blood cells or lead to increased destruction of red blood cells, leading to anemia. Certain medications, such as chemotherapy drugs, can have a suppressive effect on the bone marrow, impacting the production of red blood cells. Additionally, treatments such as radiation therapy and certain surgeries can also contribute to anemia. Anemia symptoms depend on the cause and how bad the anemia is. Anemia can be so mild that it causes no symptoms at first, but symptoms usually then occur and get worse as the anemia gets worse. Some general symptoms of anemia include tiredness or weakness, shortness of breath, pale or yellowish skin, irregular heartbeat, dizziness or lightheadedness, chest pain, cold hands and feet, headaches. There are several different types of anemia, each with its own underlying causes and distinct symptoms. Here are some of the most common types of anemia. Iron deficiency anemia. This is the most common type of anemia, which occurs when the body doesn't have enough iron to produce hemoglobin. It can be caused by blood loss, poor absorption of iron, or a lack of iron in the diet. Specific symptoms of iron deficiency anemia includes brittle nails, blue color to the white of eyes, desire to eat ice or other non-food items. This desire is called pica. Thalassemia. This is a genetic disorder that affects the production of hemoglobin, resulting in a shortage of red blood cells. Bone deformities, slow growth, and dark urine are symptoms of thalassemia. Anemia of chronic disorders, a CD. This type of anemia is caused by chronic diseases such as cancer, HIV, AIDS, and rheumatoid arthritis, which can interfere with the body's ability to produce red blood cells. Sickle cell anemia. This is an inherited form of anemia in which the red blood cells are crescent-shaped instead of round, making them more likely to get stuck in blood vessels and break down. Specific symptoms include pain crises, vision problems, and swelling of hands and feet. Pernicious anemia. This is a type of anemia caused by a deficiency of vitamin B12, which is needed to produce red blood cells. Symptoms of pernicious anemia may include numbness of limbs, memory loss, and depression. Aplastic anemia. This is a rare type of anemia in which the bone marrow doesn't produce enough red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Symptoms include bleeding gums, easy bruising, and skin rash. Diagnosing anemia. typically involves a combination of medical history, physical examination, and blood tests. Here are the common diagnostic tests used to diagnose anemia. Complete blood count, CBC. This test measures the number of red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets in the blood. It also measures the levels of hemoglobin and hematocrit, which are important indicators of anemia. Blood smear. This test involves examining a sample of blood under a microscope to check the size, shape, and color of the red blood cell. Serum ferritin level. This test measures the amount of iron stored in the body, vitamin B12 and folate levels. These tests measure the levels of vitamin B12 and folate in the blood, which are important for red blood cell production. Hemoglobin electrophoresis. This test is used to diagnose certain types of anemia, such as sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. Bone marrow biopsy. This test involves taking a sample of bone marrow from the hip bone to check for abnormalities in the production of blood cells. It is usually only done in cases of severe anemia or when other tests are inconclusive. The treatment for anemia will depend on its cause and how serious it is. People who have mild anemia may not need treatment. If your anemia is caused by medicines or another health condition, your doctor may change your treatment to manage or stop your anemia. Your doctor may prescribe medicines to help your bone marrow make more red blood cells. If your anemia is caused by an autoimmune disease, you may need medicines to suppress your immune system. Iron supplements can increase the iron in your body. This may help treat iron deficiency anemia. Vitamin B12 supplements or shots can help treat vitamin B12 deficiency anemia. Blood transfusion, blood and bone marrow transplant are some other procedures that can be used to manage the disease. Thanks for watching.